गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम इन हार्ट 111। टुडेज टॉपिक इज जुवेनाइलिटी एंड फ्लावर बड डिफरेंशिएशन। जुवेनाइलिटी, व्हाट इज जुवेनाइलिटी? अ सीडलिंग फेज पासेस थ्रू डिफरेंट स्टेजेस इन इट्स लाइफ साइकिल। यू सी इट इन फिगर 11.1। दीज स्टेजेस आर एम्ब्रियोनिक ग्रोथ, जुवेनाइलिटी, मैच्योरिटी, senescence and death. Juvenility is a developmental stage in seedling plants during which it is unable to produce flower. The plant doesn't respond to inductive environmental signal to induce flowering in juvenile phase. The length of juvenility varies between plants. The annual plants have very short juvenility period. The perennials have long juvenile period. The juvenility period may be 20 to 30 days in rose, Rosa species, to almost 40 years in beech, Fagus sylvatica. See it in table number 11.1. Table 11.1 depicts length of juvenile period of some important plants. First one is rose, Rosa species. The juvenile period is only 20 to 30 days, whereas in grape it is 1 year. In stone fruits it is 2 to 8 years, almond 3 to 4 years, apple 4 to 8 years, pear 6 to 10 years, citrus species 5 to 10 years, mango, Mangifera indica 5 years, guava, Psidium guajava 3 to 4 years, banana 1 year, papaya carica 4 to 12 months, pomegranate 2 to 3 years, mahua 25 years, cape gooseberry 30 days, cherry 3 to 5 days, peaches 3 years, pistachio 4 to 10 years, walnut 5 to 9 years, okra 45 days, cucumber 80 days, tomato 60 days, brinjal 60 days. And now you see in diagram seedling cycle in plants showing different phases of juvenility. These are seeds. It takes germination, juvenile phase, then transition phase, adult phase, and development of flower and zygote, and finally fusion of male and female gamete, embryonic phase, and then again seed. Second bypass transition, axillary buds. Axillary buds generally develop vegetative phase as well as reproductive phase, and then it goes to flowering stage. From the table, it appears that juvenility of plants varies from as short as 20 to 30 days to as high as 25 years. In perennial plants, in which juvenility is longer, it is of much concern in view of production. Characteristics of juvenility leaf form. It is different from that found in mature plant. In juvenile plant, leaf is usually vigorous. Such type of leaf is observed in mandarin, kino, guava, etc. The morphology may also be different. In case of acacia, juvenile leaves are bipinnately compound, while in adult they are linear. Growth form. Juvenile shoot growth appears whip-like. The shoot grows parallel to the main stem. Such shoot is known as water sprout, for example citrus and guava, in which it is occur. Presence of thorns. In citrus, propagating the plant from juvenile phase of mandarin shows thorns above the bud union. However, when propagated from mature part of mother plant, shows no thorn above bud union. See it in figure number 11.2, which represents juvenility and maturity stages. Apple, pear and citrus seedlings in juvenile phase are thorny. This state disappears when seedlings attain adult phase. You see in case of citrus, juvenile phase has thorn in the left and in right mature shoot. When there is no thorns, and it indicates the mature stage. Leaf retention. In juvenile phase, leaf remains attached with shoot throughout the season, during winter also, whereas it falls in mature plant. Root emergence. If propagated, juvenile part root faster than mature portion of plant. Flower bud differentiation. Before taking notion of flower bud, it is imperative to learn buds. What is bud? A bud is an immature shoot system which is often surrounded by protective scale leaves. The bud develops into a lateral branch, a flower or an inflorescence. In fruit production, development a bud into a flower or an inflorescence is much desired aspect. The development stages in flowering is as under. Flower bud differentiation. It is also known as flower induction. For bud differentiation to occur, there is enhanced cell division in the central zone below the apical part of the meristem. Due to cell division, there is differentiation of parenchyma cells which surround the meristem into flower primordia. See it in figure number 11.3. Initiation in second stage, initiation of flower formation takes place. Flower development, it includes length of time from induction to bloom. During this period, the flower is generally receptive to pollination. Opening of flower, that is anthesis, is the final stage of development. You see it in the development, differentiation of flower bud, cortex, pith, vascular tissue, xylem and phloem, bud primordium, internode, node, apical meristem, and then leaf primordium. A flower is a modified reproductive shoot, basically a stem with an apical meristem that gives rise to a leaf primordia. In contrast to vegetative shoot, the flower shoot is determinate as the apical meristem. It stops growth after the flower parts are formed. Some of the leaf primordia of the flower are modified as reproductive sporophyll, stamen and are carpel. The period of flower bud differentiation of some important fruit crops are noted under table 11.2. In 11.2 table, flower bud differentiation and flowering in some important fruit crops. You see it fruit, apricot for example. Time of fruit bud differentiation is August and time of flowering, flower opening, that is after next spring. Peach, cherry, apple, pear and mango almost same, but in mango flower bud differentiation takes place during October and time of flower opening next spring. Types of bud: simple bud, it grows into vegetative shoot, it is also known as leaf bud. Mixed bud, it grows into a shoot with the flowers, it is also known as flower bud. Compound bud, it grows into both leaves as well as flowers. Factors influencing flower bud differentiation. There are so many factors which affect the differentiation of bud. In between juvenility and maturity in plants, there is transition phase. Transition, the phases, at this phase there is changes in the pattern of morphogenesis and cell division. This process leads to flower bud differentiation. Consequently, flower organs, sepals, petals, stamens and carpels develop. The changes taking place in apical part of the meristem in the shoot apex, which render apical meristem to produce flower, are collectively referred to as floral evocation. The flower evocation is dependent to signal received from leaves and exported to shoot apex. The signals are also produced in the roots, which regulate flowering in plants. It has been shown that adventitious root formation inhibits flowering in shoot. In many plants, removal of roots promote flowering. Hence, it appears that roots produce flowering inhibitors. On the other hand, root synthesizes both GA and cytokinin. Both have promotory role in flowering. These substances are transported to the shoot via the xylem. In some plants, at the time of photoperiodic induction, increased amount of cytokinin from xylem exudates from nodes have been observed. From the finding, it appears that signals emanating from the leaves are transported both to apex and root during photoperiodic induction, bud differentiation of flower. As a result, the root produces addition chemical signals that are exported to shoot apex, which control flowering in plants. The signals leading to flower induction includes endogenous and external factors. These factors are agendas, endogenous factors. Carbon nitrogen supply, CN ratio. High ratio of carbohydrates to nitrogen favors flowering. In young plant, heavy application of nitrogen, which lowers CN ratio, delays flowering. The plant which are old, big, and having higher CN ratio flowers heavily. With respect to CN ratio, there may be four situations such as high nitrogen and low carbohydrates flower forms. High nitrogen and enough carbohydrates flower forms. Moderate nitrogen as well as carbohydrates, good growth and abundant flower formation. Low nitrogen and high carbohydrates, formation of only few buds. When there is no growth on the plants, there is accumulation of photosynthesis, which helps in maintaining CN in proper balance. In contrast, in active growth phase, there is utilization of photosynthesis, changes CN ratio, and accordingly influence flower to form. Auxin promotes flowering in citrus, lychee, and custard apple. Naphthalene acetic acid has indirect effect on flowering through production of ethylene, hence it is used to induce flowering in pineapple. Application of auxin after photoinductive cycle increases flower differentiation. It has been established that auxin interferes with the photoperiodic reaction, which takes place in leaves and hinders synthesis of florigen and ultimately flowering, hence exogenous application of anti-auxins promote flowering. GA causes rapid growth of flower primordium. It induces flowering in long day plants. In these plants, increase in flowering may be due to elongation of internodes. In plants which require cold can be brought to flowering following GA application, for example in chrysanthemum. Cytokinin BA accelerates flowering in chrysanthemum. It counters the inhibitory effect of auxin in flower initiation. It has been shown that cytokinin redirects the flow of assimilates essential for flower formation. External application of ethylene in induction short period inhibits flowering. However, it stimulates flowering in pineapple and mango. Growth inhibitors like TEBA, MH and morfactins favor development of flower in many plants. TEBA 2,3,5 dihydrogen benzoic acid interferes with auxin transport and promotes flowering in pineapple, tomato and several other species. Growth retardant, which are anti-gibberellins, promote flowering in apple, stone fruits, tomato and azalea species. However, these substances have demerit of reducing fruit size, hence their use remains restricted. In the 1930s, Mikhail Chalekhin postulated the existence of a universal flowering hormone and called it florigen. In a study, it was observed that if a non-induced plants were grafted onto an induced plant, the former plant flowered even if it were never exposed to inductive day length. Similarly, grafting a lateral shoot from an induced plant on a non-induced plant induced flowering of the latter. Such effect can be transmitted from plant to plant through several graft generations. It seems that the hormone appears to be translocated from the induced leaf to apical meristem, which leads to its change from vegetative to reproductive state. However, florigen has not been isolated and characterized so far. Genes, when plants undergo phasic change from juvenile to adult, EAFL gene synthesizes. The gene is responsible for functioning for truncating juvenile and adult phases, which induces early flowering. The HASTY genes promotes juvenility in plants. The loss of function mutation in this gene leads to early phase change from juvenility to adult, and there is an early flowering in plants. Now we discuss environmental factors. These are temperature. It forms very common apprehension that spring season brings profuse flowering. Those who are associated to agrotourism tend to arrange visit of orchard, especially in temperate zone during spring, in order to make visitor enjoy spring bloom. It means there is some correlation between flowering and season. It is accounted into temperature. Temperature has a role in programming flowering in seasonal pattern. Hence, due to availability of a particular temperature in a particular season, flowering occurs at the same time each year. Exposure of plants to low temperatures favors flowering. Biennial plants like carrot, radish, celery, sugar beets, cauliflower, cabbage, turnip, etc. upon exposure to 0 to 10 degrees centigrade temperatures come into flowering. This is known as vernalization. These plants don't flower normally until second year of growth is exposed to low temperatures. Likewise, in temperate zone, fruits like apple, pear, peach, plum, apricot, etc. also require vernalization for flowering. In these plants, low temperature requirement is commonly known as chilling requirement. Chill hours are roughly the number of hours between the temperature of 32 to 45 degree Fahrenheit. They have chilling requirement below 7 degrees centigrade for about 4 to 6 days for the bud to bloom in spring. You can see in table 11.3. Table 11.3, chilling requirement of some temperate fruits. Apple 1000 to 1500 hours. Blackberry 200 to 500 hours, pear 1500 hours, 200-300 hours low chilling varieties, 800 to 850 hours high chilling varieties, and peach 250 to 300 hours low chilling varieties, plum European 700 to 1000 hours, plum Japanese 300 to 500 hours, almond 250 to 500 hours, walnut 700 to 1500 hours. And likes. So, photoperiod, some plants flower only when their reproductive requirement are fulfilled. Based on photoperiodic response to flowering, plants are characterized into three broad categories, which are as under: long day plants, LDP, short day plants, SDP, and day neutral plants. In case of long day plants, in these plants, flowering occur only in long day situations, whereas in short day plants, in these plants, flowering occur only in short day situation, and in case of day neutral plants, in these plants, flowering is not regulated by day length. Besides this, there are intermediate day plants in which flowering takes place only in narrow day length limits, for example, between 12 to 14 hours. Another category of plant known as MB photoperiodic, in which flowering takes place in long day or short day but not at intermediate day length. Now, second parameters is light intensity, duration, as well as quality influences, bud differentiation and flowering. Plants receiving high light intensity flowers properly than low light ones. This is the season that in fruit trees other parts which receives more light intensity flowers profusely than the inner part which fails to receive proper light intensity. In low light regime, there is reduction in supply of carbohydrates to plant. Consequently, flowering is disturbed. Quality of light is important in flowering. Far red light, FR, is generally invited to flowering, while the red light RL, natural sunlight, promote flowering. Of course, response depends upon nature of plant. LDP as well as SDP in plant pigment called phytochrome receives photoperiodic signal. It is found in PR phytochrome red wavelength 660 nanometer and PFR phytochrome far red wavelength 730 nanometer forms. The ratio of PR and PFR is more important than their absolute level. It has been observed that exposure of plants to far red light 730 nanometers immediately after red light brought short day plant flowered, whereas LDP didn't flower. Managemental factors and flower bud differentiation. Nutrients, they play a role in deciding better to reproductive growth in plants. Nitrogen in general increases above ground T2 growth, thus it favors carbohydrate utilization within plant. Long day plants have more flowering only in excess of carbohydrates and short day plants in excess of nitrogen. phosphorus being involved in protein synthesis, cell division, potassium in translocation of sugar, magnesium in carbohydrates, metabolism, iron in nitrogen, fixation, zinc in biosynthesis of oxygen, boron in transportation of carbohydrates, among many more influences, differentiation of flour, but directly or indirectly. Third one is moisture. Non-availability of moisture extends the time of flour bud differentiation. There is a reduction in number of flower primordia if water deficit occurs. Rain synchronous flowering is observed in mandarin. If rains fails, no big bahar, July-August flowering, flower appears in mandarin. In guava, pomegranate, custard apple, support, etc., rain is one of the important determinants in flowering. Thank you for patience sharing.